will require you to remember where God brought you from. See, I say that because remembering where God brought you from will keep you humble.
Yes.
We know who fell because of pride. The opposite of humble is pride. So if you want to end up like him, don't remember where God brought you from. But if you want to be part of the glorious church, then remember where God brought you from, because it will keep you humble.
Man, Jesus.
See, God never said following him was going to be easy. There will be times when you just want to give up and call it quits. There will be tempting times when you want to compromise the word of God and take the short and easy way. There will be times where you question the promise of God that's in the word. There will be times when God is silent.
Amen.
There will be.
Yeah.
When everything you're doing in ministry seems like it has no use. When we can't see revival take place right before our eyes, right at this very moment, you have to remember where God brought you from. Because that will keep you going. And that will help you press forward. See, the name Samuel, it means heard of God. It means asked of God. I am convinced after studying this that she, Hannah, named Samuel that, because she needed to be reminded that she made a vow to God.
Right.
As a mother, she longed for a child. Her cry unto God was so desperate. But then again, you read that she went and presented her baby to the Lord. How easy I think that was, because there are no verses in between. How could she do that? How could she dedicate her most prized possession to God? Because she made a vow. Because she remembered where God brought her from.
Yes.
See, I can't imagine the moment. I'm not a mother, but I have a mother. And I know the way she loves me. So I can't imagine the moment Hannah presented Samuel to the Lord, knowing he was never going to come back. He was never going to come back home with her. How difficult that must have been. See, at that moment, she could have backed off.
Yeah.
She could have called it quits.
Yeah. Right.
Quits at a moment of weakness when we want to hold back our everything that we want to give to God. We want to hold back our dedication.
Yes.
We can call it quits.
Yes.
But remembering where God brought you from is what will keep you going. She said, no, I named him Samuel because I was in my affliction and God heard me.
Yep.
God heard me when I was in trouble. She remembered the promise to God. I wonder if we can relate. You know, I was blind once, but now I see. I was lost once, but now I'm found. It'll require you to remember where God brought you from.
Amen.
I wonder if we can all just stand.
Thank you.
Just raise our hands and we're going to pray, making your genuine, humble prayer. Jesus, I come before you. God, knowing that I am a sinner, knowing that you have done so much in my life, and that I could never, ever pay off what you have done for me, God. And so, like those vessels that were set apart, devoted, dedicated unto the work of the tabernacle, Jesus, right now, God, I ask you to mold my heart. Jesus, shape it the way you like. Help me to be dedicated unto you. Help me to be holy, set apart, acceptable, devoted unto you, Jesus. Because I know you will only accept that which is holy. Help us today. Help us today. today, Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, I pray.
So